Now, what this says to us is the fact that there are now more community transmission and these people have been out and about in the community. And that is of now concern to Queensland Health and, of course, concern to me. So Dr. Young will go into more detail about these particular cases. But what this means for Greater Brisbane is that we will have to go into a 3-day lockdown. This is the UK strain. It is highly infectious. Now, we need to do this now to avoid a longer lockdown, and that lockdown will commence at 5 p.m. this afternoon. That lockdown will be for Greater Brisbane, which is Brisbane, Logan, Moreton Bay, Ipswich and Redlands, and will commence at 5 p.m. this afternoon. That'll mean that our schools will close from tomorrow. And as I said, we need to do this. This will also enable our health authorities to get on top of the contact tracing. This is a huge job now that we have to do because we've got more of this community transmission. I know this will mean some disruption to people's lives, but we've done this before and we've got through it over those 3 days in the past. And if everyone does the right thing, I'm sure that we will be able to get through it again. So that means that people will only be able to go out for those 4 essential purposes. And Dr. Young will go into more of that in detail. But of course, those 4 essential services are for food, for exercise, for essential work, and of course, medical. Now, the other news is that one of these people also travelled to Gladstone. So that means now for the rest of Queensland, we will be putting in that compulsory mask wearing for the rest of Queensland, and limiting gatherings to your own home to 30 people. This is essential, everyone, that we do this to stop further transmission. We've seen what's happened in other countries. I don't want to see that happen to Queensland. I don't want to see that happen to Australia. I know this is a really big call. I know it's very tough. We've got Easter coming up. We've got school holidays coming up. But let's do it now and let's do it right. And let's see if we can come through at the other end. We'll also be reviewing it on Wednesday night as well. We'll know whether there's any further community transmission, because the last thing we want to see is our roads clogged on Thursday night heading for Easter vacation. So this is necessary. It's the UK strain, highly infectious. And the last thing I want to see is our most vulnerable in our community or people ending up in our COVID wards in our hospitals. So this is a protective measure, but it's absolutely the right thing to do based on the health advice. Let me say that again. This is the right thing to do based on the health advice. We do not take these measures lightly. These are very, very difficult decisions, but they are done to keep Queenslanders safe. They are done to protect everybody and to make sure that we stop the spread of this UK variant. So look, I'll hand over to Dr. Young and then to our health minister, and then we're happy to take some questions. Thanks, Dr. Young.
So we have 4 new community acquired cases overnight, which means that the current cluster that we're dealing with has 7 cases. The initial 2 gentlemen and now a brother of one of those that we think could be that link between the PA doctor who was infectious 2 weeks ago and this cluster. Then we have 2 colleagues of the second new case who have tested positive yesterday, and one of those people was in Gladstone for 3 days while they were infectious, so we're working very closely there to identify venues that person was at. Then very late last night, I was notified of another case who happens to be a nurse working in the COVID ward. She did some shifts there, but I'm not sure that's where she's acquired it. We will need to wait for genome sequencing results that we should get back late tonight or tomorrow morning, which will make it clear. Her sister is also positive, and we're not sure where the transmission has happened there. Again, we need the genome sequence results. So we have two cases there that we're investigating as to how they acquired the infection. They have recently been in Byron Bay during their infectious period. So we now have significant community transmission and significant numbers of venues of concern all through Brisbane, and we know that people have moved from Brisbane out into the broader community, which is why I have advised that we need to ask people who live in Greater Brisbane, those five local government areas that make up Greater Brisbane, to stay home for the next 3 days until we can work out how much community transmission there has been, and we can contact all of the contacts who have been in these many, many venues. That's critical. So those four reasons that people can leave home, as were in place last year and in January this year when we had that 3-day lockdown, are, of course, for essential work and to buy essential supplies, food, medications and so forth, to look after a vulnerable person, and for exercise. And people, as in the past, can have up to 2 visitors to their home, and they can go out and exercise in a family group, or if they're by themselves, with one other person from a different family group. So that's very important, and all that will be put in place from 5 p.m. this afternoon so people can complete their day. But I would hope, and I'm sure that this will not occur, that people don't choose to leave Brisbane during this time. It's important that people go home. If your home is normally outside Brisbane, you've come into Brisbane to work for the day, as we know a lot of people do, of course you can then return to your home. But anyone who has been in that Greater Brisbane area since Saturday the 20th of March is now required to follow those same requirements, that is to stay wherever they are except for those 4 reasons. Now, people who live outside Brisbane, because we know there has been a lot of movement since the 20th of March when these cases first appeared in the community, anyone outside Greater Brisbane, those 5 local government areas, has also had restrictions placed upon them. We will also be limiting visits to aged care, to disability accommodation services, to hospitals and to prisons, because they are the most vulnerable in our society. Plus, people can only have gatherings in their own home of up to 30 people in total. And also, anyone who's going out to dine or to go to pubs needs to be seated. So the 1 per 2 square metre requirement remains, with that additional requirement that people must be seated. And that's very important because we know that reduces mingling. Then the other requirement is, could everyone please wear masks? So in Greater Brisbane, that's for everywhere, that you're indoors, unless you're in a single room by yourself, of course not in your own home, but if you're elsewhere, except if you have a medical exemption, so you can't wear a mask because that would be dangerous for you, or you're doing extreme physical exertion, again, that would be dangerous. Really, it's important to wear a mask. So when you go to the shopping centre, when you go on public transport, when you're in a rideshare car, please wear a mask. Then from the rest of the state, outside the 5 local government areas that make up Greater Brisbane, I'm asking that you wear a mask when you can't physically distance, when you're inside and in public transport. They're the important risk areas. So if people could all please get out those masks that I know you have. There is not a requirement to wear a mask outside, particularly if you can socially distance. Thank you.